Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brothers. And Joseph brought a bad report of them to his father. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age. Also, he made him a tunic of many colors. But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him. Now Joseph had a dream, and he told it to his brothers, and they hated him even more. So he said to them, "Please hear this dream which I have dreamed. There we were, binding sheaves in the field. Then behold, my sheaf arose and also stood upright, and indeed your sheaves stood all around and bowed down to my sheaf." And his brothers said to him, "Shall you indeed reign over us? Or shall you indeed have dominion over us?" So they hated him even more for his dreams and for his words. Then his brothers went to feed their father's flock in Shechem. And Israel said to Joseph, "Are not your brothers feeding the flock in Shechem? Come, I will send you to them. Please go and see if it is well with your brothers and well with the flocks, and bring back word to me." Now when they saw him afar off, even before he came near them, they conspired against him to kill him. Then they said to one another, "Look, this dreamer is coming. Come, therefore, let us now kill him and cast him into some pit, and we shall say, 'Some wild beast has devoured him.' We shall see what will become of his dreams." But Reuben heard it, and he delivered him out of their hands, and said, "Let us not kill him." And Reuben said to them, "Shed no blood, but cast him into this pit, which is in the wilderness, and do not lay a hand on him." Then they lifted their eyes and looked, and there was a company of Ishmaelites coming from Gilead with their camels, bearing spices, balm, and myrrh, on their way to carry them down to Egypt. So Judah said to his brothers, "What profit is there if we kill our brother and conceal his blood? Come and let us sell him to the Ishmaelites, and let not our hand be upon him." So the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit, and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver, and they took Joseph to Egypt. So they took Joseph's tunic, killed a kid of the goats, and dipped the tunic in the blood. Then they sent the tunic of many colors, and they brought it to their father and said, "We have found this. Do you know whether it is your son's tunic or not?" And he recognized it and said, "It is my son's tunic. A wild beast has devoured him. Without doubt, Joseph is torn to pieces." Now Joseph had been taken down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him from the Ishmaelites who had taken him down there. The Lord was with Joseph, and he was a successful man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his hand. Now Joseph was handsome in form and appearance. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast longing eyes on Joseph, and she said, "Lie with me." But he refused and said to his master's wife, "How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?" So it was as she spoke to Joseph day by day that he did not heed her. But it happened about this time, when Joseph went into the house to do his work, and none of the men of the house was inside, that she caught him by his garment, saying, "Lie with me." But he left his garment in her hand and fled and ran outside. So she kept his garment with her until his master came home. Then she spoke to him with words like these, saying, "The Hebrew servant whom you brought to us came in to me to mock me. So it happened as I lifted my voice and cried out that he left his garment with me and fled outside." Then Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison. But the Lord was with Joseph and showed him mercy, and he gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison. It came to pass after these things that the butler and the baker of the king of Egypt offended their lord, the king of Egypt. So he put them in custody in the house of the captain of the guard, in the prison, the place where Joseph was confined. And Joseph came in to them in the morning and looked at them and saw that they were sad. So he asked Pharaoh's officers who were with him in the custody of his lord's house, saying, "Why do you look so sad today?" And they said to him, "We each have had a dream, and there is no interpreter of it." So Joseph said to him, "Do not interpretations belong to God? Tell them to me, please." Then the chief butler told his dream to Joseph and said to him, "Behold, in my dream, a vine was before me, and in the vine were three branches. It was as though it budded. Its blossoms shot forth, and its clusters brought forth ripe grapes. Then Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes and pressed them into Pharaoh's cup, and placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand." And Joseph said to him, "This is the interpretation of it. The three branches are 3 days. Now within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head and restore you to your place, and you will put Pharaoh's cup in his hand according to the former manner when you were his butler." When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was good, he said to Joseph, "I also was in my dream, and there were three white baskets on my head. In the uppermost basket were all kinds of baked goods for Pharaoh, and the birds ate them out of the basket on my head." So Joseph answered and said, "This is the interpretation of it. The three baskets are 3 days. Within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift off your head from you and hang you on a tree, and the birds will eat your flesh from you." Now it came to pass on the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he made a feast for all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. Then he restored the chief butler to his butlership again, and he placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker, as Joseph had interpreted to them. Then it came to pass at the end of 2 full years that Pharaoh had a dream, and he sent and called for all the magicians of Egypt and all its wise men. And Pharaoh told them his dreams, but there was no one who could interpret them for Pharaoh. Then the chief butler spoke to Pharaoh, saying, "I remember my faults this day, when Pharaoh was angry with his servants and put me in custody in the house of the captain of the guard, both me and the chief baker. Each of us dreamed according to the interpretation of his own dream. Now there was a young Hebrew man with us there, a servant of the captain of the guard, and we told him, and he interpreted our dreams for us." Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph, and they brought him quickly out of the dungeon, and he shaved, changed his clothing, and came to Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "I have had a dream, and there is no one who can interpret it." So Joseph answered Pharaoh, saying, "It is not in me. God will give Pharaoh an answer of peace." Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Behold, in my dream I stood on the bank of the river. Suddenly 7 heads came up on one stalk, full and good. Then behold, 7 heads, withered, thin, and blighted by the east wind, sprang up after them. And the thin heads devoured the 7 good heads. Then Joseph said to Pharaoh, "And the 7 good heads are 7 years, and the 7 empty heads blighted by the east wind are 7 years of famine. Indeed, 7 years of great plenty will come throughout all the land of Egypt, but after them 7 years of famine will arise, and all the plenty will be forgotten in the land of Egypt." Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Inasmuch as God has shown you all this, there is no one as discerning and wise as you. You shall be over my house, and all my people shall be ruled according to your word. Only in regard to the throne will I be greater than you." And Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh and went throughout all the land of Egypt. Now in the 7 plentiful years, the ground brought forth abundantly. So he gathered up all the food of the 7 years which were in the land of Egypt and laid up the food in the cities. Then the 7 years of plenty which were in the land of Egypt ended, and the 7 years of famine began to come. The famine was over all the face of the earth, and Joseph opened all the storehouses and sold to the Egyptians. When Jacob saw that there was grain in Egypt, Jacob said to his sons, "Why do you look at one another?" And he said, "Indeed, I have heard that there is grain in Egypt. Go down to that place and buy for us there, that we may live and not die." So Joseph's 10 brothers went down to buy grain in Egypt. Now Joseph was governor over the land, and it was he who sold to all the people of the land. And Joseph's brothers came and bowed down before him with their faces to the earth. Joseph saw his brothers and recognized them, but he acted as a stranger to them and spoke roughly to them. Then Joseph remembered the dreams which he had dreamed about them and said to them, "You are spies. You have come to see the nakedness of the land." And they said to him, "No, my lord, but your servants have come to buy food. Your servants are 12 brothers, the sons of one man in the land of Canaan, and in fact, the youngest is with our father today, and one is no more." But Joseph said to them, "It is as I spoke to you, saying, 'You are spies.' In this manner you shall be tested. If you are honest men, let one of your brothers be confined to your prison house, but you go and carry grain for the famine of your houses, and bring your youngest brother to me, so your words will be verified, and you shall not die." And he took Simeon from them and bound him before their eyes. Then they went to Jacob, their father, in the land of Canaan, and told him all that had happened to them, saying, "The man who was lord of the land spoke roughly to us and took us for spies in the country. Then the man, the lord of the country, said to us, 'By this I will know that you are honest men. Leave one of your brothers here with me. Take food for the famine of your households and be gone. And bring your youngest brother to me, so I shall know that you are not spies, but that you are honest men.'" And Jacob their father said to them, "You have bereaved me. Joseph is no more, Simeon is no more, and you want to take Benjamin. All these things are against me." So the men took Benjamin, and they took double money in their hand, and arose and went down to Egypt, and they stood before Joseph. Then he lifted his eyes and saw his brother Benjamin, his mother's son, and said, "Is this your younger brother of whom you spoke to me?" And he said, "God be gracious to you, my son." Then Joseph could not restrain himself before all those who stood by him, and he cried out, "Make everyone go out from me." So no one stood with him while Joseph made himself known to his brothers. And he wept aloud, and the Egyptians and the house of Pharaoh heard it. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Does my father still live?" But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed in his presence. And Joseph said to his brothers, "Please come near to me." So they came near. And he said, "I am Joseph, your brother, whom you sold into Egypt. But now, do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life." Then he fell on his brother Benjamin's neck and wept, and Benjamin wept on his neck. Moreover, he kissed all his brothers and wept over them, and after that his brothers talked with him. Now the report of it was heard in Pharaoh's house, saying, "Joseph's brothers have come." So it pleased Pharaoh and his servants well. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Say to your brothers, 'Do this, load your animals and depart, go to the land of Canaan, bring your father and your households and come to me. I will give you the best of the land of Egypt, and you will eat the fat of the land.'" Then they went up out of Egypt and came to the land of Canaan to Jacob their father. And they told him, saying, "Joseph is still alive, and he is governor over all the land of Egypt." And Jacob's heart stood still, because he did not believe them. But when they told him all the words which Joseph had said to them, and when he saw the carts which Joseph had sent to carry him, the spirit of Jacob their father revived. And Israel said, "It is enough. Joseph, my son, is still alive. I will go and see him before I die."